soon be entering ZDR's atmosphere.
The bounty for this mission does not seem appropriate.
Entering the atmosphere in T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
That elevator leads to the depths of an underground facility. Signal quality is likely to be low. Remote communication remains a problem. Try to connect to the facility's network when you reach the bottom. That way, you can remain in contact. Any objections, lady?
Uploading data.
So, you've accessed the network station. Well done, Samus. I have reviewed your vital signs and video log from the data you uploaded. I've run a full analysis, but I cannot account for why you lost consciousness. My readings indicate dramatic physical changes in you. Whatever caused these changes seems to have stripped you of most abilities. You might call it physical amnesia. That brings me to your assailant. I am checking the Federation database against your video log. It appears to have been a Chozo. The attacker's identity is not yet clear. I have determined that you are somewhere within the depths of ZDR. Your top priority should be to return to your ship on the surface. This situation is precarious. Trust your instincts as you navigate upward. This planet appears to consist of multiple areas. Shuttles, elevators, and other modes of transport connect them. Keep an eye out for ways to reach the surface. The ship's location is marked on your global map. Check it for yourself. You may encounter pockets of low temperature. Your Metroid DNA renders you vulnerable to such environments. Spending time in cold areas will be harmful to you. There are many such cold areas scattered underground. Do not enter them with your basic power suit. One final thing. Underground interference is preventing radio transmissions. Check in with me at any network stations you find.
Uploading data.
Both EMMI you encountered were clearly trying to capture you. They may have been hacked. If so, it's reasonable to assume all EMMI will be hostile. EMMI, send out a pulse to detect vibrations in the air within a certain range. Essentially, they can hear you. Upon detecting vibrations, an EMMI enters surveillance mode to track their source. Stay out of its line of sight when this happens. Otherwise, the danger to you increases dramatically. An EMMI that has seen you will begin pursuit. Part of the pursuit protocol is to seal the EMMI zone exits. You will be trapped inside. To survive, you must leave its range of pursuit. Evade the EMMI and it will disengage. This will also unseal the exits. An EMMI never leaves its assigned zone. Their control system must permit them to operate only within that range. I estimate a 99% probability of death if an EMMI captures you. There may be a very small opportunity to escape, but exploiting this window will be virtually impossible. The EMMI are immune to your current weapons. You lack the unique energy used to defeat the first EMMI. Your only option now is to evade capture and find an exit. Your highest priority in an EMMI zone should be simply to survive.
Uploading data.
There was no record of your assailant in the Federation database. However, there are records of a Chozo warrior tribe. There is a strong possibility the two are connected. You have seen the warrior tribe's architecture and artifacts on this planet. I conclude that this was one of their settlements. But why would someone lead you here and send the EMMI after you? The footage of the ex-parasite may have been staged to lure you in. The situation remains unclear, but your priority hasn't changed. You must return to the ship. You have activated the Magma Supply System that has restored power to the closed thermal doors. Seek them out to proceed. Continue to search for the unique energy you employed against the first EMMI. It is the only way you can confront them. Unfortunately, this energy is limited. You may have noticed it dissipating after an EMMI is destroyed. There are 6 remaining EMMI hunting you. You have no means to confront them. Remember that.
Thank you. Thank you.
Uploading data.
CPR appears to be powered by thermal energy. Magma is pumped from the planet's interior and routed from there. I have located the central routing system for the magma. It is here in Cataris. Samus, your current suit cannot protect you as you explore Cataris. The extreme heat of the lava is too much for it. Under no circumstances should you enter high temperature areas. I know the shuttle somewhere above here. Use it to find a path forward. There is one other thing to discuss. It is your new Phantom Cloak ability. The Phantom Cloak prevents the EMMI from detecting you. Thus far, your only option was to run. Now, bypassing them is also an option. Use this to reach your objective. Note that using the Phantom Cloak severely decreases your mobility, and direct contact with an EMMI will still result in capture. It is up to you whether to hold your position. Just be aware of your surroundings. The Phantom Cloak is useless once an EMMI sees you. You will need to evade capture until it gives up pursuit. The Phantom Cloak can remain active after your AIM has been depleted. It will consume your life energy instead. Consider it a desperate measure. Remember, it cannot drain your energy down to nothing. Judicious use of this technique will improve your probability of survival.
Uploading data.
EMMI stands for Extraplanetary Multiform Mobile Identifier. It can procedurally modify and enhance its own capabilities. Its ability to configure itself to fit into narrow spaces is a standard feature. Any EMMI you encounter will likely do so as it pursues you. You are not capable of destroying their armor plating. This would be true even at your full capabilities. You are faced with overwhelming power. Accept your helplessness. Study each EMMI carefully, and use the Phantom Cloak to advance. There are risks even here. The Phantom Cloak reduces. Do not hesitate to destroy an EMMI whenever you discover more. You need energy. This was not one of your original priorities. However, I see no other way to accomplish your goal. These existential threats cannot be sanctioned.
Thank you.